February 6th was Bob Marley's birthday. I'm not big on celebrating birthdays, but I can acknowledge someone who lived like a prophet, somebody whose name is etched in eternity, and that is definitely Robert Nesta Marley. His birthday was February 6th. It's also Reggae Month. You know, the government decided to make February Reggae Month, I guess because Bob's birthday is February 6th and Dennis Brown's birthday is February 1st. So I think that was the motivation behind making the month Reggae Month. You know, and besides, a lot of visitors come to the island because of Bob Marley's birthday anyway. So I guess they decided to make the most of it in their own way. You don't have to ask. I don't really participate in that. I celebrate roots music every day, so I don't need a reminder to do that. It's also Black History Month, and I don't really celebrate that either. You cannot reduce Black History to one month. It is impossible to do that. You know, I celebrate Black History every day. This is how I present. I celebrate myself every day. I don't need a month to do that. I don't need permission to do it either. And besides, Black History Month was really something that Black Americans, white mommies and white daddies created for them. You know, so it's not really a global thing. It's just that we're so influenced by American culture that we take on everything that they do. But really and truly, that was for them. For me, Bob embodied all of what I think Christ consciousness means. Thousands of years from now, people will still speak his name. His life was a life of service. And he said it. He said it in interviews. He said it in his music, that his life is not for him. What he does is for the people. What he does is for others, not for himself. He dedicated his life to doing something meaningful for humanity. You know, his music was a music full of message. He could have easily chosen to do what's popular. He chose to do music with a message, an unpopular message as well. This is the message of Rastafari. This is the message of Black liberation. And let's not reduce Bob's music to one love, because it is way more than that, you know. And besides, One Love wasn't really written for us. That message wasn't really written for us Black people, because we're full of love. We've always been full of love. We've never been the people who are destructive, who are hateful. We've been a people of love, a people of unity. And you will see that throughout African culture, throughout African ethos, you will see that we've always been about elevation, about growth. And that is the message of Rastafari as well. It is seeing God in everything and seeing, and I don't mean God in the sense that a lot of you see God. Seeing the oneness of everything, that there is no separation, right? Anything in earth. That has always been us. So that One Love message really wasn't for us. But Bob's music was definitely revolutionary. So it's not no kumbaya type of music. Music always had a message that would burn a little slow fire still, you know. It's so nice and everything, but there is always a little fire in there for Babylon. Let's not reduce it to kumbaya and, you know, weed smoking music. You know, we can talk about weed smoking in another video again, because people have reduced Jamaica and Rastafari to being, you know, weed smokers, stoners. You know, they've reduced us to stoners, and Rastafari, of course, is way more than that. Bob, to me, has done what no political leader has done, no religious leader has done, no religion has done, no spiritual guru has done, and that is to reach to every corner of this earth with a message of love, peace, and hope. The whole world was rocked by this half-breed Bongolax Rastaman out of Jamaica. I mean, just think about that. Just think about that. Nobody in the world has had that impact. No other culture, no other genre of music has done that. This came out of this little island of Jamaica, but bigger than Jamaica, it came out of Rastafari. That's what Bob music is. Bob music is the message of Rastafari. We cannot never forget that he's a Rastaman. And so his music is Rastafari. To the core, it is Rastafari. Many people want to deal with Rastafari like it's a gimmick. It's something to make comedy of. It's something to make light of. But it isn't. As I said, the impact that Rastafari has had on the world is massive. Rastafari is all that's carrying Jamaica. Yes, we have sun, sand, and sea. They can go anywhere in the Caribbean for sun, sand, and sea, but people choose to come here because of the energy that is here, and it is the spiritual energy that is here. So black people, Jamaicans, black people in the region, globally, need to embrace Rastafari more. Need to embrace reggae music more, because it is ours. It was born out of us. Well, leave it now for other people running on it. Them are running. They've already infiltrated Rastafari and watered it down. And so the energy that Rastafari should be pushing, it is not even there anymore. You know, and the music also, they've infiltrated the music. So it can easily be copied. It's not ours anymore. They don't need to book us anymore. I don't know if you ever noticed, there are some huge reggae shows, reggae festivals in California. Sometimes when you look at the artists, you don't even see one Jamaican artist on there. Sometimes if you see Jamaican artists on there, they're on the small stage. Jamaican artists, where reggae music was born, the artists from here are put on the small stage. And this is happening all over the world, right? So we saw a few years ago when a big reggae band, white reggae band, won the Grammy, right? So these things are happening because we don't own our own stuff. You know, we wait for white people to come and take it from us and copy it. And the only reason I think that they could have copied Rastafari and reggae music, not Rastafari, they can't copy Rastafari, but they can copy reggae music, is because they've taken the spirituality out of reggae music, and you can't copy our spirituality. I just want to encourage us to embrace our own stuff. Embrace yourself. When you are embracing these things, you are embracing yourself, because these things came from you. It is your energy that Bob Marley is representing, not just his. What he speaks about is all of our pain. Everything that he speaks about is about us, for us. And I don't mean just us in the diaspora, but us on the continent of Africa as well, because there's pain, ancestral pain, on both sides that we need to heal from. So big up to Bob Marley. You know, he left an incredible legacy. I always say that, you know, if there is indeed a heaven that Bob Marley must reach, it is impossible for a man to do this magnitude, this level of work that he did while he was here. Right, the level of service that he lived in while he was here, the level of impact that this man has made on humanity, it is impossible that he not make it to heaven. Bob has done more than the work for many, many lifetimes. You know, I even question, what was he doing in his past lifetime that could revered him for the work that he did in this lifetime. These are the things that we must aim to do. We must aim to be the best version of ourselves, aim to grow. We must aim to grow spiritually and prepare ourselves for the next life, you know, because we may not get it right this time, but we can get it right the next time around. And based on the work that we've done. Big up also to Rita Marley, you know, because Bob laid the foundation and she really took it to a whole other level. So big up to the Queen Rita Marley, always. So I have some clips from the Bob Marley Museum. We went there for his birthday. I haven't been out in a long time, so I said, you know, Tiff, come. I could go a road a little bit. It wasn't for long because we got there somewhere around 4 o'clock and then it finished at 6, so we weren't there for long. But we saw a couple performances and, you know, it was a nice vibe. Lots of people there and some vendors and yeah, so I'll show you some clips from that. And then I met a few people who follow the channel, so it was good to meet you guys. Make sure you subscribe. I know a lot of you are watching and you haven't subscribed, so just subscribe. And even if you don't want to subscribe, you know, the ones who are here, you don't really want me to know, so you don't watch, but you now watch obsessively. Big up on yourself. Thanks for the views. Just subscribe and like and share. And tell me what you think. What do you think about living a life of service? Do you agree that this is the point of spirituality? Because that's what I believe. I believe that the point of spirituality is to live a life of service. And when you really elevate to the next level, when you do something impactful with your life, something that really impacts humanity and changes people for the better, you live in partnership with God. So essentially, as Christians would say, you know, God lives through you. And so this is how Christians should live, but most of them don't live. So most of them live and work for money. They don't really work in service and then get paid from the work that they do in service. No, generally it's about accomplishing and climbing ladders. But tell me, do you agree that we ought to be living a life of service? You know, do you live a life of service? And share in the comment section, what do you do in service to God, in service to humanity, in service to yourself, in service to your community? What do you do?
A bigger thing though, that not even so long.
Concert, okay. And she did it. God bless her widow.
saying myself. Yeah, so she did. A couple of them, Alvaro was the main one, but if you want to go on this, I think this French guy is performing.
These are your pieces, Aya?
They're from the store. I didn't know from the style of food. Yeah, man.
See the work we have for black woman on TikTok.
Yes.
Don't make nothing in the world stop you.
Okay.
Yeah?
I will.
Love our thing, man. Love it.
Thank
you. I always see you as a young girl too. And you talk to the young woman them like you make them look at them. Don't stop, don't make nothing stop you. All of them take them thing at 20 times, you put it 21.
I do.
That is the strength that you need. Hear that?
Oh, that's nice. I love that.
Energizing and unifying the body and the spirit. Yeah, exercising the mind so you have clearer thoughts. Yeah, so Ita Royal Wines and Roots, J.A. have all the roots tonic wine them. Yeah, allow when needed. That's it.